I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder.
Welcome to the Herd News. I'm Stephen Carlson. Last Saturday was the 20th anniversary for 9/11, a terrorist attack by Al-Qaeda on the World Trade Center. 3,000 people died in 9/11 because the terrorists hijacked flights 11 and 175. After this, the U.S. government started the War on Terror, invading Afghanistan. After all this, they eventually caught Osama bin Laden, killing him in May 2, 2011. Now on to Caleb with news about the soldiers coming home.
Over 20 years ago, after the events of 9/11, then-President George W. Bush signed the Joint Resolution, which authorized force upon those responsible. After 20 years of armed conflict, troops in Afghanistan were finally brought home. Over that 20 years, the U.S. lost an estimated $3.4 billion to supplies and 2,500 troops. Our thoughts and prayers go out to all and all of the people who experienced losses. Now back to the studio.
Sports have long claimed a central position throughout American life. In the aftermath of 9/11, as they did during previous moments of such a crisis, sports helped shape a national response to events beyond the playing field. Almost immediately, there were questions. In the months that followed, sports set an emotional cadence for a grieving nation. Ballparks, racetracks, and arenas offered fans a place to come together and cheer. The rituals of sports were extended to commemorate those who had lost their lives on 9/11. We also honor all of those who protect us. Now on to Chase with a special report.
Hello, I am Chase Sportsman, and this is Ms. Morris, and I'm reporting from the History Room. Today we're going to be asking Ms. Morris some questions about what she was doing on 9/11. Ms. Morris, how old were you when 9/11 happened?
I was in my early 20s. I had three kids. Two of them were in school, and I had a baby.
Do you remember anything about what happened on 9/11?
I just returned from taking my two older kids to school, and I came in to feed the baby, and I had my TV going on Good Morning America. I remember the report was that they believed there was an accident of a plane hitting one of the World Trade Towers. And it wasn't very long after that, there was another plane that hit the second tower. I remember them continuing to play it over and over and over.
Well, thank you, Ms. Morris, for your report.
No problem.
So Chase Horseman signing out.
Thank you, Chase. Now on to the weather.
Thank you. Today on Wednesday, there's going to be a high of 78 and a low of 55. Tomorrow on Thursday will be a high of 83 and a low of 60. On Friday, there's going to be a high of 83 and a low of 65. On Saturday, there's going to be a high of 92 and a low of 67. And on Sunday, it gets warmer with a high of 93 and a low of 72. Now back to you in the studio.
This week's edition of Nodaway-Holt the Herd brought to you by...
Come on down to the City Star Quick Stop, located on Highway A in Maitland. Stop by to fill up on food, drinks, and gas.